Good evening, students. We are going to discuss the question answers from the chapter 3. Today, I'm going to discuss first the true and false, and then we'll go for the differences and the short notes. The long questions, I will show you the page number and I'll discuss the answer in the next part of the video. Question number 1. State whether the following statements are true or false. Number 1, a computer shows unusual behavior due to a virus attack. That is true. A computer virus is intentionally made to disturb the proper function of the computer system. True. There is no difference between computer virus and a biological virus. That is false. There is number 4, a computer virus can be removed from the system through vaccination. That is false. Question number 5, a computer virus is destructive in nature. That is true. Question number 6, a system gets affected by the virus automatically. That is true. Question number 7, a computer virus replicates itself within the amount of available memory. That is also true. Antivirus software is specially designed to protect the entry of viruses into the system. That is true. A system gives an alert when a virus affects the storage media is connected. That is also true. Once an antivirus is loaded, your computer will never be affected by viruses. That is false. It can get affected. Now we move to the question number 2, where it is given, give 2 examples of each different types of viruses. So wood sector viruses, name Danish Pro and Quox, Q-U-O-X, Quox. Next, we go for the worm virus, Swen, S-W-E-N, Swen, and then Scalper, S-C-A-L-P-E-R, Scalper. Number 3, Trojan. 2 types of Trojans are Bacto and Nuco. Question number 4, Macrovirus, Bloodhound and Melissa. M-E-L-L-I-S-S-A, Melissa. Question number 5, bomb virus, Jerusalem, happy birthday, 30th. Question number 6, slit virus, is Frodo and brain. Now we move to the question number 1 of subjective part. Distinguish between the following. One is biological virus, another is computer virus. So what is biological virus? Biological virus are unusual symptoms affect physical part of living beings. It affects the body parts. Examples are cold and cough, seasonal fever, etc. What is computer virus? It is a malicious programs which affect software and hardware or system. It destroys computer's data. Example, Trojan horse, worms, bomb, etc. Now, we go to the question number 2 of the subjective parts. Question number 2 is the difference between program virus and macrovirus. So if we see the difference between program virus and macrovirus, program virus, these viruses directly attack the program files of the system with the extension exe, sys, com, etc. These are executable file. Mainly, they are executed like system files. When it were loading the system, that time these files are executed. So they mainly manage the programs, execution of the programs and all. Next, macrovirus. These types of viruses attack the data files of the system. means using the program file, we get some kind of data file where we store the data. Like Microsoft Office, if you are starting with Microsoft Word, Word is a program file. But when you create a document inside the Word, that is called the application or data file. This data file get affected with the help of macro viruses. Next, question number three, what are the difference between viruses and antiviruses? It is a malicious code that has the ability to duplicate and send copies of itself to other computers through internet. Means once the virus is getting affected to your system, and if you are connected to any other devices in a network through internet or LAN, whatever it is, it can duplicate and send a copy to another devices connected to your system. Antiviruses, it is a software designed to protect your computer system against the malware of malicious programs which can attack your computer system. So when your computer is attacked by any kind of unknown programs or any kind of attack destroying program, then who can protect your system is antiviruses software. Now we go to the question number two, state two ways of classifying computer viruses. I'll just go to the two ways of computer viruses. Computer viruses is a malicious code that has the ability to duplicate and send copies of itself to other computers through internet. It can corrupt, alter, delete, freeze your computer and interfere with its operation. So viruses can be classified into two categories on the basis of its behavior. One is general infectors, another is system infectors. So we move to the next part. Here we are going to discuss about the definitions of various things. So first definition is about the worms. These viruses are programs which do not affect the functioning of the system. Once they enter, they attack the security zone of a computer system, copies and multiply itself by using computer networks and security flaws. Flaws means any kind of loophole or any kind of faults of a security system. Then Trojan. These viruses are better known as Trojan horses. They are also computer programs, but destructive in nature. They move around the valid programs and get executed with a flashy opening screen. When suddenly it will open another screen and it will give you a dialog box and it will attract your computer system. Next one, bomb. As the name suggests, the explosion takes place in the form of sudden disaster inside the system. These viruses remain inactive for a long time and wait for a specific date or specific event for the disaster. So it, like I told you about the bomb, one example, happy birthday 30th. So 30th is the date, or good happy means Friday the 13th. So these dates are the specific date when it suddenly executes, or maybe some other kind of situations where it gets automatically activated with the help of date or time. Thank you. This is my first part of the question answer, long question answers part. I will discuss with the next video. And I would like to inform you today, the 4th of August, I was supposed to have my classes due to the heavy power shortage over here. All our systems were down for last 7 hours. I could not do my class. So I'll be taking my class very next day, maybe on 5th evening. I will let you know through the messages, and my second video will be coming up soon. Thank you.